you ever watched Formula One? Many racers compete in a circuit to be the fastest to cross the finish line. Their maximum speed can reach 360 kilometers an hour, but right when they get across the finish line, their velocity is almost zero. How is that possible? We will do a little bit of a review. Speed. Speed, a scalar quantity, is determined by dividing the distance traveled by an object by the time elapsed. The international unit, or SI unit, for distance is meter, and for time is second. In reality, it is difficult to race at a constant speed for the entire duration of the race, so usually the average speed is calculated. For example, a Formula One circuit has a length of 4 kilometers, and the cars need to complete 72 laps to finish the race. The winner completes all of them within 2 hours. So the total distance of the car is equal to 288 kilometers, and the winner's average speed is 144 kilometers per hour. Converting the units into SI units, we can determine that its average speed is 40 meters per second. Velocity. Velocity, a vector quantity, is determined by dividing the total displacement by the time elapsed. For example, as the driver goes past the halfway point for the first time, the average velocity can be counted by measuring the length between it and the start line, divided by the time elapsed. But as the drivers return to the initial place where they cross the finish line, their displacement is nearly zero, because it is close to the same point as they start the race. Thus, their average velocity is also negligible compared to their average speed. We've made a simpler explanation on displacement and velocity, along with the introduction to scalar and vector quantities, somewhere in the channel. Now, back to the circuit. Before they race along the track, the car is at rest in the start line. When the red lights are turned off, do you think they just magically move at 200 kilometers per hour from rest? Of course not. In physics, there is a certain term called acceleration. What actually happens is, when he sees the red lights turned off, the driver will push on his accelerator. His car will gradually move faster until it reaches a certain velocity. A body is said to be in acceleration if its velocity is changing. As the velocity is a vector quantity, the change can be in the magnitude or in the direction of the movement. Thus, we can say acceleration is the rate of change of velocity. If the velocity is increasing, we call it acceleration. When the velocity is decreasing, we call it deceleration or retardation. The standard unit for acceleration is the unit of velocity divided by the unit of time, which becomes meter per second squared. The acceleration can be better understood with the following example. If a car starts from rest and reaches a velocity of 72 kilometers per hour in just 4 seconds, its acceleration can be counted as the initial velocity is zero since the car starts from rest, the final velocity is 20 meters per second, and the time elapsed is 4 seconds. Acceleration is then equal to 20 divided by 4, which is equal to 5 meters per second square. If the car is indeed increasing its velocity by 18 kilometers per hour each second, the car undergoes uniform acceleration. But if the car has different changes of velocity each second, for example, a higher increase due to the downhill or slowing due to the speed bump, it is called non-uniform acceleration.